The January 16th, 2020 meeting of the Woodbridge Township Board of Education will please come to order. Roll call, Mr. Secretary.
Ms. Anderson?
Here.
Ms. Bourdain?
Here.
Mr. Harris?
Here.
Mr. Molnar?
Here.
Mr. Sedana?
Here.
Mr. Treebosser?
Here.
Mr. Velez?
Here.
And Mr. Delapietro?
Here. Mr. Secretary, as required by the Sunshine Law, please read the notice of meetings.
Thank you, Mr. President. The New Jersey Open Public Meetings Law was enacted to ensure the right of the public to have advance notice of and to attend the meetings of public bodies at which any business affecting their interest is discussed or acted upon. In accordance with the provisions of this act, the Board of Education has caused notice of this meeting to be published by having the date, time, and place thereof posted as follows: January 3rd, 2020, emailed to the Home News Tribune, the Star Ledger, and the Municipal Clerk's Office, posted in Avondale Middle School and the Board of Education Administration Building.
Okay. Ms. Anderson, please read the closed session statement.
Thank you, Mr. President. I would like to motion for the approval of the following closed session statement. In compliance with the Sunshine Law, the Board must go into closed session in order to discuss subjects exempt from the public portion of our meeting. The discussions to be held in closed session will be regarding personnel matters. Additionally, the Board will receive attorney-client advice regarding a possible public question. Any information regarding a closed session discussion will be released to the public when the reasons for discussing these matters in closed session no longer exist.
Thank you. Do I have a second?
Second.
Seconded by Mr. Molnar. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay, motion carries. Okay, we'll be back around 7.
Good evening. The Colonia High School Jazz Band is a premier musical ensemble made up of students in grades 9 through 12. The Jazz Band performs at a wide variety of school and community events, and students must audition in order to be selected for this group. Although the ensemble is modeled after a 1930s swing-era big band, the students also perform a wide variety of other styles, such as blues, funk, and rock and roll. The students focus heavily on the development of self-confidence, self-expression, and improvisational skills. Tonight's selections include The Chicken and Jersey Bounce by Duke Ellington and the Star-Spangled Banner. Mr. Perdoni.
Thank you.
Please rise for a salute to the flag and a moment of silence. Okay, I'd like to thank the Colonial High School Jazz Band for their performance tonight. Excellent job. They're under the direction of Mr. Paradoni. I'd also like to recognize Mr. Lottman tonight. He's out in the audience. Finally, good seeing you again. Okay, do I have a motion to reconvene?
So motion.
Okay, I have a motion by Mr. Molnar. Second it?
Second.
Okay, by Mr. Treadweiser. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, any opposed? Okay, motion carried. Roll call, Mr. Secretary.
Ms. Anderson?
Here.
Ms. Bourdain?
Here.
Mr. Harris?
Here.
Mr. Molnar?
Here.
Mr. Sedana?
Here.
Mr. Tamborello?
Here.
Mr. Treebwasser?
Yes.
Mr. Velez?
Here.
And Mr. Della Petro?
Here. Okay, will someone make a motion to approve the minutes of the previous meeting?
So motion.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Okay, are there any additions or corrections? Okay, I have a motion by Mr. Molnar, seconded by Mr. Treeweiser. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carried. Mr. Secretary, please state for the record any notices of bids received by the board.
Mr. President, there are no bids to report this time.
Okay. Okay, Dr. Zega, please state for the record the superintendent reports for the month of December of 2019.
Mr. President, I have the following reports. Student registers and fire drill report, suspension reports for elementary and secondary schools, bomb threat reports, and the reports of the attendance officers.
Very good. Okay, Dr. Zega, please introduce our student representative.
Daniel Tejas from Woodbridge High School. Daniel earned the Seal of Biliteracy in French and Spanish and was recently awarded the coveted Good Citizenship Award. Daniel is an accomplished dancer and serves as the president of both dance club and show choir. Daniel is a senior class officer and is currently ranked number one in his graduating class. Daniel has recently been accepted to Princeton University and plans to study chemistry next year. Daniel?
So, for school number 9, there was a winter concert held in the first week of January. Their Panthers partner shipped with the Woodbridge High School football team and the Colonia High School boys basketball team on STEAM projects. Their family learning night have begun, and they would like to remind everyone that there will be a Team LeGrand comedy night fundraiser at the Avenel Performing Arts Center on February 8th at 8 p.m. Tickets are still available, and they would like you to go to eventbrite.com and type in Team LeGrand for ticket information. For school number 19, students in third grade are participating in family writing, while students in grade 5 are participating in family science and math. kindergartners are participating in a Ready, Set, Read program, and the school guidance counselor has been working with fifth grade students to develop a peer mentoring program for structured recess. As for Avenel Middle School, their family literacy night was a great success. Their band and chorus members performed to a large crowd at their winter concert. The family book buffet promotes their students' love of reading. Their boys and girls basketball teams had an outstanding season, both qualifying for the playoffs. Bowling season begins later this month. Recently, the Students' Council school-wide door decorating contest was profiled on News 12 New Jersey. The Heroes and Cool Kids from Colonia High School visited Avenel Middle School to share their empowering message with their students. Avenel Middle School will also be participating in the upcoming Township Food Drive. Their Community Service Club collected goods for Holiday Express, for Hackensack Meridian Health, and the Woodbridge Animal Shelter. Their Sidekicks Mentoring Program continues their collaboration with School Number 19, where their students assist the students from School 23 to transition to middle school. They can also congratulate Woodbridge Middle School and wish them continued success as they return to their new school. It was a pleasure for them to host their sixth grade students and staff. As for Woodbridge High School, the FBLA club had four students placed in the top 10 at the North Central Regional Competitive Event in December: James Benino, Gino Trejo, Giselle Patel, and Adrian Encarnizacion. For the silent choir, they put on a play for kindergartners and first graders at school number 18. They went caroling at the board office, firehouse, library, church, and all around Woodbridge High School. They also performed at the winter prep rally, led and performed with fifth and sixth graders at Roosevelt School Holiday Concert in Rahway, and collaborated with and taught fifth and sixth graders Silent Night, which was performed for deaf families at Roosevelt School in Rahway. For the Woodbridge High School choirs, the jazz choir performed at the 2020 reorganization meeting of the Middlesex County Board of Chosen Freeholders on January 7th. The concert choir and wind ensemble performed for the General Assembly of the State of New Jersey on January 14th. The Woodbridge High School Choir will travel to compete in Washington, D.C. in April. The Woodbridge High School Choir will also host their annual spring vocal concert on May 27th at 6 p.m. The Woodbridge High School Choir sang at the Mayor's inauguration on January 1st. This week, the Social Justice Club, Ecology Club, and International Culture Club are hosting their sixth annual Peace Week at Woodbridge High School. For the Interact Club, the Thanksgiving Food Drive acquired donations to fill 56 baskets, which were distributed to Barron families and other local families in need. As for the Drama Club, Woodbridge High School, the Drama Club performed their fall one-act play, Rumors, by Neil Simon on January 14th, and the Woodbridge High School senior play, The Drowsy Chaperone, will be held on March 19th, 20th, 21st at 7 p.m., and on Sunday, March 22nd at 2 p.m. There will be a special performance for senior citizens on March 17th at 4 p.m. For the boys bowling team, their record is 13-0. For the boys bowling team also won the Charlie Simon Baker Tournament, the Warren Wheeler Tournament, and the Brick High School Tournament. For girls bowling, the record is 10-2-1. That team also won the Warren Wheeler Tournament. Matt Muldoney bowled a 300 game on January 4th at the Brick High School Tournament. The Woodbridge High School bowling program hosted the Maria Tufaro Classic at Majestic Lanes on November 30th and raised over $3,000. For the boys soccer team, Piero Tuffer was named to the 2019 Central 1 Selection Sectional All-State Second Team. Marcos Piastre received an honorable mention at the Soccer Coaches Association of New Jersey annual banquet, and Kaina Da Silva made all-division. For the girls' soccer team, Leticia Da Silva, Olivia Gatone, and Destiny Pagan all made all division. Also for the boys soccer team, they received the Greater Middlesex Conference White Division Sportsmanship Award. For cross country, for the cross country boys, Jaden Rose made all division, and for the girls, Janice Igbenabero made all division. As for tennis, the girls team had Brianna Davis make all division and all Greater Middlesex Conference. For volleyball, the girls team had Nicole Bialy make all division, all Greater Middlesex Conference, and Millie Mullings and Mary Alice Urena made all division. The girls volleyball team finished 16 and 11 and won the Greater Middlesex Conference White Division Championship. Peter Jakovinich, girls volleyball coach, was named the Greater Middlesex Conference White Division Coach of the Year. For football, Ali Lee won all division, all Greater Middlesex Conference, first team all area, first team all group four, Star Ledger third team all state, USA Today NJ first team all state, the Home News Tribune Offensive Player of the Year, the Star Ledger Greater Middlesex Conference Player of the Year. Isaiah Allen and Jameer Brown also won all division. Jesus Cabrera and Jordan Harris won all division and all Greater Middlesex Conference, first team all area, and first team all group four. Steven Daramola and Isaiah Jackson won all division, second team all area. Justin Magera and Anthony Santino won all division and first team all area. Sebastian Montlewis won Greater Middlesex Conference all division. The Woodbridge High School football team finished 10-1 and played in the state sectional championship game and won the Greater Middlesex Conference Blue Division Championship. Joseph Lasala, the Woodbridge High School football coach, was named the Blue Division Coach of the Year, the Greater Middlesex Conference Coach of the Year, and the Home News Tribune Football Coach of the Year. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Daniel. That was a very detailed report. Excellent job. You're welcome to stay with us tonight. If you agree to stay with us, you'll be the first in a long time.
I have a dance rehearsal I have to get to, but thank you.
Okay. Thank you again.
Thank you so much.
Okay, superintendent's agenda. Dr. Zega, do you have any recommendations?
Mr. President, I have 11 items to present to the board.
Okay, do you have a motion for the superintendent's agenda?
So motion.
Do you have a second?
Second.
Mr. Harris?
Thank you.
Okay, any comments or questions from the board? Any comments or questions from the public? Seeing none, roll call, Mr. Secretary.
Ms. Anderson?
On item number 6, I will abstain in the name Marie Anderson. Yes for all other items.
Ms. Bourdain?
Yes.
Mr. Harris?
Yes.
Mr. Molnar?
Yes.
Mr. Sedana?
Yes.
Mr. Tamburello?
Yes.
Mr. Triebwasser?
Yes.
Mr. Velez?
Yes.
Mr. Della Pietro?
Yes. Policy and planning, Mr. Harris.
Thank you, Mr. President. The Policy and Planning Committee, on recommendation of the Superintendent of Schools, presents the following 6 items. I move for the adoption of the foregoing.
I have a motion by Mr. Harris. Do I have a second?
Second.
Mr. Tamburello. Okay. Are there any comments or questions from the board?
Mr. Del Pietro.
Mr. Harris.
All right, I want to jump in here and highlight 2 items. Number 5, to parents out there, elementary and middle school parents, please note that we are adjusting this year's student calendar to provide for a early dismissal on Tuesday, March the 10th. That will be the date of the forthcoming bond referendum vote. So again, please note elementary and middle school parents only that date will now be changed to a early dismissal. And secondly, item number 6, this is for even the students in the back there, as well as our faculty and staff and all parents around the district. We are adopting the student calendar for the next school year. So please take a look at that. I know Dr. Zega puts that on the website very promptly, probably as early as tomorrow, if not the early next week. The student calendar, as we have done for the second consecutive year, we're adopting a student calendar that simply reflects the federal government holiday schedule. So the calendar hopefully is without controversy for the second year in a row, and we make it a very consistent calendar. So I want to thank my colleagues for taking the politics and some of the controversy out of the calendar for the second year in a row, and staying on our path of providing a consistent and responsible student calendar. So thank you very much, Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. Harris. Are there any comments, any other comments from the board? Okay, any comments or questions from the public? Okay, seeing none, roll call, Mr. Secretary.
Ms. Anderson?
Yes.
Ms. Bourdain?
Yes.
Mr. Harris?
Yes.
Mr. Molnar?
Yes.
Mr. Sedana?
Yes.
Mr. Tamburello?
Yes.
Mr. Trebwasser?
Yes.
Mr. Velez?
Yes.
Mr. Della Pietro?
Yes. Okay, curriculum, Mr. Harris?
Yes, thank you, Mr. President. The Curriculum Committee, on recommendation of the Superintendent of Schools and Assistant Superintendent for Curriculum and Instruction, present the following six items. I move for the adoption of the foregoing.
Okay, I have a motion by Mr. Harris. Do I have a second?
Second.
Okay, Mr. Tamburello. Okay, I have a motion by Mr. Harris, seconded by Mr. Tamburello. Any comments or questions from the board?
Mr. Della Pietro?
Mr. Harris?
I get paid by the word here, so I'm going to keep on going. I want to highlight number six for the public. This is an exciting initiative that I worked on during my day job in Trenton, and that's providing for personal finance. As many parents know, it is a graduation requirement for high school students today to take a personal finance class, and the legislature saw it fit that we expand personal finance to the middle school level. So the district is going to test out how we're going to provide that next year throughout all five middle schools, but beginning this semester in Island Middle School, will be testing out personal finance for middle school at Island Middle School. So that's exciting. I want to thank the administration, Mr. Bader, Dr. Zega, for taking the initiative to find out what works, what doesn't work, what we should be teaching our kids in relation to personal finance, and do it at an age-appropriate manner. So thank you very much for taking the initiative.
Thank you, Mr. Harris. Any other questions from the board? Any questions or comments from the public? Okay, seeing none, roll call, Mr. Secretary.
Ms. Anderson?
Yes.
Ms. Bourdain?
Yes.
Mr. Harris?
Yes.
Mr. Molnar?
Yes.
Mr. Sedana?
Yes.
Mr. Tamburello?
Yes.
Mr. Trebwasser?
Yes.
Mr. Velez?
Yes.
Mr. Della Pietro?
Yes. Finance and Insurance, Mr. Tamburello.
Thank you, Mr. President. The Finance and Insurance Committee, on recommendation of the Superintendent of Schools and the Business Administrator Board Secretary, presents the following 10 items. This evening, I move for the adoption of the foregoing 10 items.
Okay, I have a motion by Mr. Tamburello. Do I have a second?
Second.
Mr. Sedana? Okay, are there any comments or questions from the board?
Yes, Mr. President.
Yes.
If I may, we are presenting the Township of Woodbridge School District, County of Middlesex Auditor's Report for the fiscal year ending June 30th, 2019. And at this time, if we can turn it over to Mr. Andrew Hudelick from Hudelick & Morrison, PA, our auditors, for a brief description of what he found and our diagnosis on our fiscal health. Mr. Hudelick.
Thank you, Mr. President, members of the board. Pleasure to be here. As the board member indicated, this is the report on your financials as of June 30th, 2019. The timing of the report was delayed a little bit. Again, we waited for some information to come from the state that's required to be reported in your CAFR, and they were not as timely as they need to be to get the information to us. With respect to the audit opinion on the financial statements, it's a clean opinion. Which indicates that we agree on a material basis with everything that's reported in the financials. Your financials continue to be very strong. Fund balance increased from 18 year end to 19 year end. And in terms of reportable findings, we had four that were mentioned in the report. The state requires us to report back findings, any findings that we do come across. These dealt with a missing business registration form. There were differences in the ASSA reporting and also the Department of Transportation reporting to some small degrees, and with respect to reporting of compensated absences. I'm happy to report that we did do some preliminary work just recently, going over some of the ASSA reported numbers as of October 15th, 19, and we found a very good improvement with respect to those items being reported. So So with that, again, a clean opinion on the financial statements, and I'd be happy to answer any questions from the members of the board.
Through the board president.
Mr. Muller.
Just real quick, I know I ask this question, it seems like every year. Mr. Hudlick, in our internal structure, do you feel we're satisfying our segregation of duties in our internal structure?
You know, as a matter of fact, yes, you know, we do study that. We don't issue an opinion on your internal controls, but obviously we study it to determine the scope of our testing and to determine whether or not, again, we feel that we have to extend any procedures. And we have not found any issues in terms of your segregation duties to warrant a extension of audit procedures.
Thank you.
Yeah. Any other questions from the board?
Yeah, Mr. President.
Mr. Tyrell.
May I also have some standard questions I'd like to shout out every year. Mr. Hudlick, I know in past years we've had recommendations, minor bookkeeping errors or not even inaccuracies, just omissions from principals. I'm happy to see we had none of that this year. All the schools are documenting what comes in and what goes out, and I'm really happy to see you can confirm that. There are no minor technicalities at the schools.
That's correct. For the items that we tested, we did not come across any items that needed to be reported.
That's great to see. Yeah. We had four minor recommendations, in your opinion, and you're saying you're working on a lot of those. We're, again, waiting for data to come in, and at that time when you were checking those, we didn't have the information you needed.
That's correct.
You're satisfied. We have four recommendations. You're satisfied that they are minor?
Correct. Yeah, they're not substantive, but again, the way the department puts the audit guidelines out to us, any kind of finding, they expect us to report it in the reports.
And you still need some backup documentation on those four items?
We're still working. Well, we're working to, again, review the information that was reported at October 15th, 2019, which will actually be in the 2020 audit. But we were satisfied that the improvements have been made in that area, those areas.
Okay. Another annual question. Man hours for the public. Let them know what your task covers and how long you are in the district for us.
Yeah, actually, I hate to tell you, but we spend a lot of time. Actually, when I go back to the firm and they say your realization rates aren't so hot, but that's because we spend a lot of time. But anyway, we have in excess of 500 hours, person hours on the job, and you know it's a rigorous examination, no doubt. We cover all the areas that are necessary to give a extensive review of your financials.
Thank you for that and for your team and the time you spend with us. Are you at a position to discuss bond rating?
Oh, yeah, I'm aware of what you're, you know, yeah, absolutely, yes.
What would you classify us, or what are we rated at?
Well, you guys, the last time you went out for your bonds, you were rated a double A minus, and that's investment grade, obviously. So, you know, you're in a very good position in terms of bond ratings. You won't find many school districts that have a higher rating than that. And that's really a function of the fact that the state limits the amount of fund balance you can retain. So, you know, you're not in the business of building a fund balance necessarily. You know, if you have excess fund balance, you have to give it back taxpayers or put it in a maintenance reserve or a capital reserve, what have you. So that's why the district's ratings are a little lower. For example, the township's rating is a double A plus, you know, but they have a much higher fund balance than you're able to retain.
Thank you, Mr. Hudlick. You know, I could summarize this. The fiscal health of the school district is strong.
Very strong.
I think that's important to note as we go out again in March. As Mr. Harris mentioned earlier, we are going out for another bond referendum. And I think bond ratings and fiscal health in this audit report shows the responsibility and accountability of this board along with the township. I think it's important for the public to hear that. Once again, I thank you for all the work you put into this. You know, a lot of work here. On all of our parts, so I appreciate it, and that's all I have, Mr. President.
Any other questions from the board or comments?
Yeah, sorry, just you might not even have it off the top of your head. You said our fund balance was bigger than the prior years. Do you know what the fund balance is, what it came out to be?
Right, actually, yeah, so it increased by $6 million over the previous year, so it actually went from $44 million up to $50 million.
Wow.
But again, that actually gets turned right back because the calculation requires that you can only retain 2% of your fund balance over expenditure. So it really goes back to taxpayers and taxpayers.
Sure, right. Okay, all right, that's good. All right. You know, I think, you know, I'm not an accountant, but would it be fair to say that when we have $6 million more than the prior year, or any fund balance in general, that would say that whatever we budgeted, the administration spent properly and, you know, kept their eyes on the penny, so to speak. And
yeah, the terminology
we... over-budgeted,
right.
And by having extra money left over, that speaks to our business operations that we're spending responsibly, right. Correct?
Yeah, the terminology we utilize is positive variances, and you had positive variances on both the revenue side and the appropriation side.
Sure.
Yes.
Okay, great. All right. You just put everyone to sleep with that one. All right. Thank you.
Any other questions or comments from the board? Okay, seeing none. Any comments or questions from the public? Seeing none, roll call, Mr. Secretary.
Thank you. Ms. Anderson?
Yes.
Ms. Bourdain?
Yes.
Mr. Harris?
Yes.
Mr. Molnar?
Yes.
Mr. Sedana?
Yes.
Mr. Tamburello?
Yes.
Mr. Trebwasser?
Yes.
Mr. Velez?
Yes.
Mr. Delapietro?
Yes. Okay, technology, Mr. Sedana.
Thank you, Mr. President. The Technology Committee, on recommendation of the Superintendent of Schools and the Assistant Superintendent for Curriculum and Instruction, presents the following one item. I move for the adoption of the foregoing.
Okay. Do I have a second?
Second.
Okay. Second by Mrs. Anderson. Okay. Are there any questions or comments from the board? Seeing none. Any comments or questions from the public? Okay. Seeing none. Roll call, Mr. Secretary.
Ms. Anderson.
Yes.
Ms. Bourdain.
Yes.
Mr. Harris?
Yes.
Mr. Molnar?
Yes.
Mr. Sedana?
Yes.
Mr. Tamburello?
Yes.
Mr. Trebwasser?
Yes.
Mr. Velez?
Yes.
Mr. Delapietro?
Yes. Okay, athletics and extracurricular agenda. Ms. Anderson?
Thank you, Mr. President. The Athletics and Extracurricular Committee, on recommendation of the Superintendent of Schools and the Assistant Superintendent for Curriculum and Instruction, presents the following 13 items. I move for the adoption of the foregoing.
Okay, I have a motion by Ms. Anderson. Do I have the second?
Second.
Okay, seconded by Mr. Trebwasser. Okay, are there any comments or questions from the board? Okay, seeing none, are there any comments or questions from the public? Seeing none, roll call, Mr. Secretary.
Ms. Anderson.
Yes.
Ms. Bourdain.
Yes.
Mr. Harris.
Yes.
Mr. Molnar.
Yes.
Mr. Sedana.
Yes.
Mr. Tamburello.
Yes.
Mr. Trebwasser.
Yes.
Mr. Velez?
Yes.
Mr. Delapietro?
Yes. Okay, buildings and grounds, Mr. Harris?
Yes. Thank you, Mr. President. The Buildings and Grounds Committee, on recommendation of the Superintendent of Schools and Business Administrator, present the following one item. I move the adoption of the foregoing.
Okay. Do I have a second?
Second.
Okay, second by Mr. Tamburello. Are there any comments or questions from the board? Seeing none, any comments or questions from the public? Seeing none, roll call, Mr. Secretary.
Ms. Anderson.
Yes.
Ms. Bourdain.
Yes.
Mr. Harris.
Yes.
Mr. Molnar.
Yes.
Mr. Sedana.
Yes.
Mr. Tamburello.
Yes.
Mr. Trebwasser.
Yes.
Mr. Velez.
Yes.
Mr. Delapietro.
Yes. Okay, transportation agenda, Mr. Velez.
Thank you, Mr. President. The Transportation Committee, on the recommendation of the Superintendent of Schools and the Business Administrator Board Secretary, present the following one item. I move for the adoption of the foregoing.
Okay, I have a second. I have a motion by Mr. Velez. Do I have a second?
Second.
Trebwasser, are there any comments or questions from the board?
No.
Okay, seeing none, any comments or questions from the public? Seeing none, roll call, Mr. Secretary.
Ms. Anderson.
Yes.
Ms. Bourdain.
Yes.
Mr. Harris.
Yes.
Mr. Molnar.
Yes.
Mr. Sedana.
Yes.
Mr. Tamburello.
Yes.
Mr. Trebwasser.
Yes.
Mr. Velez.
Yes.
Mr. Delapietro.
Yes. Okay, personnel agenda, Mr. Molnar.
Thank you, Mr. President. The Personnel Committee, on the recommendation of the Superintendent of Schools and the Assistant Superintendent for Human Resources, presents the following. Tonight, I will be moving 29 items.
Okay, I have a motion by Mr. Molnar. Do I have a second?
Second.
Okay, seconded by Mr. Tamburello. Are there any comments or questions from the board? Seeing none, any comments or questions from the public? Seeing none, roll call, Mr. Secretary.
Ms. Anderson.
Yes.
Ms. Bourdain.
Yes.
Mr. Harris.
Yes.
Mr. Molnar.
Yes.
Mr. Sedana.
Yes.
Mr. Tamburello.
Yes.
Mr. Trebwasser.
Yes.
Mr. Velez.
Yes.
Mr. Delapietro.
On item number 10, I'll be standing in the name of Linda Delapietro. Yes on all other items. Okay, roll call, Mr. Secretary. I think we're done, right?
We're done.
Okay, good. Okay, Mr. Bush, do you have any recommendations?
None at this time.
Is there any old business that should be brought before the attention of the board at this time? Okay, is there any new business that should be brought to the attention of the board at this time?
Mr. President, I would just like, thank you very much. I would like to invite some members of our public to attend some activities that we have planned on a Saturday, February 1st at Woodbridge High School. At 7:30 a.m. till 11:30, we have a teacher professional development called Ed Camp Blitz. We would like to invite any parent in our district who happens to be a teacher in another district. At an Ed Camp, it's a great opportunity to share strategies and techniques, not only within our district, but with teachers from outside of our district. Any parent who would like to attend who teaches in another school district, the registration, it's free. It's www.edcampblitz.ticketleap.com. And again, it's Saturday, February 1st, 7:30 to 11:30. And it is also a free breakfast provided by Chartwell's. That same afternoon, and this is a more general invitation to anyone in the public who would like to participate in a fundraiser for the Marissa Tafaro Foundation. Marissa Tafaro was the daughter of Greg Tafaro, a great sports writer in our area, who unfortunately passed due to a serious childhood illness. And in her memory, Mr. and Mrs. Tafaro have created a foundation to raise money, which then goes back to help students and children in the community who have serious illnesses. We will be running a Tecmo football tournament. So it is anybody who remembers the old Nintendo video game. We will be using the old systems and playing a football tournament. There's a $25 donation to the foundation. And that also will be on Saturday, February 1st in the afternoon, beginning at noon. And anyone interested in the public who would like to participate in an old school football tournament for a great cause, they can email brett.hoyer@woodbridge.k12.nj.us or just show up at noon on that afternoon. We'd love to have you. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Bader. Okay, any other new business?
Yes.
Mr. Harris?
Yes. The student representative mentioned how John F. Kennedy High School had a singer, as well as Woodbridge High School provided a band and choir at the New Jersey General Assembly swearing-in ceremony just this past Tuesday. So I want to thank the administration, the central administration, as well as the administrations of Woodbridge High School and JFK High School for coordinating that activity. Our students represented themselves extremely well before the entire state of New Jersey. I know Mr. Bush, I don't know if you were at the reorganization meeting, but I saw you after the fact. Our students look tremendous, and I want to thank their teachers, their parents, and the students for participating. It looks fantastic. I saw it on Facebook just the other day that there were some concerns about the new traffic light provided by the county at the intersection of Inman Avenue and Delaware Avenue in Colonia. There were some concerns about the timing of that light, and I want to thank the Woodbridge Police Department for quickly jumping on that issue and taking a look at the timing of the traffic lights. So parents of Colonia Middle School, we are taking a look at the timing to make sure that's proper and parents can get to and from Colonia Middle School more easily. And I think that does it. You know what, I'll jump in real quick. I apologize, guys. The special bond referendum board meeting, it's advertised on our website, it's scheduled to take place here next week, Thursday, January the 23rd. To consider, the board would take formal action if approved by the Department of Education to place a ballot question before the voters of Woodbridge Township for Tuesday, March the 10th. So that bond referendum meeting will take place here at 6 p.m. next Thursday. Dr. Zega had mentioned this to me earlier. He's going to do a large-scale PowerPoint presentation to enumerate all the varying projects that would be effectuated with the successful passage of that bond referendum. So parents, community members, regardless if you have kids in the district or not, please consider attending that meeting next Thursday, the 23rd at 6 p.m. here. So I just want to give a shout out for that. Thank you. Mr. Petro, I'm all set for tonight.
Okay. Any other new business?
Mr. President.
Mr. Mulder.
Just like to bring an event that happened to the public's attention. One of our student teachers in the district, Brielle Small, she's the daughter of our safety coordinator, Brian Small. While doing her student teaching, I believe at school 20, she observed a student choking in the back of the room. Student was choking on an apple. She recognized the signs. She went over, did the Heimlich maneuver on the student. The student discharged the piece of the apple that they were choking on and saved the child. So I just want to give a congratulations to her quick thinking. And Brian, I talked to him about it, and he joked around, and he was like, all those CPR classes that I dragged her to as a child, I'm glad to see that she paid attention. And I'm sure the parents and the child are grateful that she did pay attention. So just a congratulations to her and for what she did.
Yeah, she did a great job. Okay. Any other new business? Okay, just like something real quick. We heard the auditor's report tonight. It was actually very good news. You know, everybody on this board works hard, you know, to make sure that we do things right and you know, on a straight and narrow. Dr. Zega, yourself and Mr. Wolferman, congratulations on an excellent job. You had an excellent report. That's because of you guys and your staff. So just want to, you know, thank you and keep up the good work. Okay, in keeping with our past practice, we'll open this portion of the meeting for statements from the public. If you wish to say something, please come to the microphone, provide your name, the part of the township in which you reside, for the record, and please limit your comments to no more than 5 minutes in accordance with Regulation 1100D. Okay, I will not answer any questions until you have completed your 5 minutes to allow you the fully opportunity to say what you need to say, as to not to interrupt your time. Anything from the public? Any questions or comments from the public? Okay, seeing none, we'll close the public portion. Okay, will the chair will enter a motion to adjourn?
So motion.
Okay, I have a motion by Mr. Molnar.
Second.
Second. Mr. Treadweiser. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, any opposed? Okay, ayes have it.